Your work week sounds like this, but then your weekend somehow still sounds like this.
Screen time is over, Avery.
But it doesn't have to.
Okay, get in the car. We're going to Overland Park.
Whoa, are we going indoor skydiving? Can we ride the streetcar? Mom, this is cool.
Family-friendly fun of Overland Park with big city perks of Kansas City. KCOP, close to home, far from routine.
Bree and Sid in the morning.
Bernard McGurk and Sid Rosenberg.
Sleep with one eye open.
Life, sports, politics.
Stay woke.
Mischief.
Oi.
Live, local, on it. 77 WABC.
Always a thrill to have Chaz Palminteri in studio, that one-man show. I told you, I'm on record saying time and time again, I love the movie with Robert De Niro. I love the Broadway show. Really was wonderful. The music, Jerry Sachs. But you got to, if you've never seen Chaz do the one-man show where he plays every single character by himself, then you really have no idea just how great The Bronx Tale is. I'm telling you. It's just, it's remarkable. And he's doing it again. Coming up in Huntington, the Paramount Theater, the great Chaz Palminteri. I love your outfit today, by the way. Abu loved it, too. You look great.
Well, thank you so much, Sid. Thank you. No, I'm looking forward to it. I love the Paramount Theater. I'll be there June 23rd, this week, Sunday.
Sunday night.
7:30.
That's right. And if you've never seen it, this is the original show that started it all, that Robert De Niro saw, that had the movie and the musical. And now I actually licensed it to Francois Oustad, and it's doing it in Paris right now. I'm going to be going to Paris to see it. Wow. The one-man show, he's actually, it's a big hit there in Paris.
That's unreal.
Yeah,
see,
I know.
But you've got it, and we'll get to some of the stuff we want to talk about, but you've got it all going on, right? I mean, you've got a daughter who's incredibly talented. So last night, Danielle goes, who's on the show tomorrow? I go, you know, Joseph Abu, Chaz Palminteri. Oh, don't forget, Chaz Palminteri, June 30th, we're going to see his son. I go, don't forget, I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. But I guess we're going to go see your son perform?
That's right.
June 30th?
June 30th.
We're
going to
be
right
there.
That's fantastic. Are you going? You're going to the,
we're
to
going.
The show?
Your
oh
wife, Tiana, called Danielle,
yes.
And we're coming.
Oh, you're coming to show. Oh, that's right. You know what?
It's a big deal,
it's
right?
A very big deal. That's right. My wife is producing this coffee thing, and it's fantastic. It's called the Coffee Concert. It's really fantastic.
And your son is going to...
My son Dante is doing his original songs, and he's doing his albums coming out, so... And my daughter's performing, too. My daughter, Gabrielle, is performing. Both of them are performing.
The apples did not fall far from the tree.
No, you know what? They're really very talented. They're fantastic. And
you know, I said, Dante, so your father once drove me back and forth to his restaurant. He's my chauffeur.
That's right. I know.
No, that's great, though, Chaz. You're only as happy as your unhappiest child, so you must be elated.
I'm elated. You know, it's so true. You could be the most successful man in the world, but... If you're not happy with your children, you're not.
So true.
It doesn't matter. Nothing matters. You could have all the money in the world, be successful, but the happiness of your children matter more than anything.
Yeah, no question. No question.
No doubt about it. Now, when you go to Paris, you're going to perform the show in Paris?
No, I'm not performing it. I licensed it to Francois Oustad, who's performing it in Paris right now. It's a hit. It's a huge hit in Paris.
That's unbelievable.
I'm going there June 2nd. I'm leaving. I'm taking my family to see it there in Paris.
that's wild.
You think you can sit there?
July 2nd. I'm sorry.
July 2nd. Do you think you can sit there and enjoy it? I'm being serious. He's a great actor. I know he is. And I know it's been a big hit in Paris. But can you sit there and enjoy it without being ultra critical of the guy who's playing you? You
but
can.
I don't speak French.
Oh, that's true. You're like...
So I don't speak French, so I'm not going to know.
Right.
But I'm going to watch it. I'm going to know what he's saying because I know it. I've done it so many times, but I'm going to watch it, and it's going to be exciting.
He's going to call you up on stage, I'm sure. You're the guy. You're him. And you're going to get a rousing round.
So.
Let me tell you something. Americans don't often get a rousing round of applause in France.
Actually, I'm really... I'm very loved in France.
You are?
Yes, I am. Very much. Very much. But you know where the biggest? Japan.
Japan.
Figure
that out. Are you
serious? Yes.
For the movie or for the Modern Family?
Bronx Tale, Usual Suspects, Bullets Over Broadway, Japan.
Really?
I go Japan, forget about it. I'm Elvis.
When was the last time you went to Japan?
I've never been there. But they come to my restaurant.
Yeah, they do.
When all the Japanese people come to my restaurant on 46th Street, 30 wow. West 46th Street.
That's right, between 6th and 7th.
Between 6th and 7th. Between 5th and 6th.
That's what I'm saying.
5th and 6th. And when they come there, they come right over to me. Oh, my God, Bronx Tale, Usual Suspect. I have to sign all these CDs and
that's
everything.
That's hilarious.
Wow. Yeah, it's fun. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
I know, it's pretty cool.
So is that cooler than being bigger on Belmont Avenue, which is cooler for you, Japan or
well, Belmont home? Avenue, I was always big on Belmont Avenue. Right. Come on.
But it's nothing like going into a sushi restaurant and just being swamped.
I'm telling you, Japan,
Steph.
I'm huge. I'm Elvis in Japan.
That is amazing.
Yeah, it's like incredible.
Hey, you know, speaking of a Bronx Tale, there is a story in the news this morning. This Bonanno crime family, this kid, he had his dad whacked. He paid somebody $200,000 to have his dad whacked in a McDonald's drive-thru in the Bronx.
I got to tell you, boy, I love being Italian, but Italians, boy, you got to watch your back.
I tell you, it ain't easy.
He's trying to kill his brother,
it ain't easy.
Too. Yeah, trying to kill his brother, yeah. too.
That's trying right. to kill his yeah. brother. You know, when it comes to money, Bernie, when it comes to money, I don't know, you just... Some people, you just can't trust anybody.
Yeah, yeah it's right. Terrible. Terrible. It's a terrible thing. Well, you know, somebody else who represents part of the Bronx, not where you're from, but part of the Bronx as well as Queens.
Yes.
And she has now become, according to Charlie Kirk, the biggest star in the Democrat Party.
Right.
He said she's the biggest. And you've been texting me and Bernie and tweeting about this the last couple of days.
Yeah.
How about the latest comments from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez?
Yeah, well, you know what? She's, what is she? You know, come on. And I give everybody, you know, listen, everybody should work hard, be successful, and that's fine. But you can't make comments like it's like the concentration camps. You can't say things like that.
In fact, you were in Germany not that long ago and saw that.
I went to Dachau, yep. And I saw the films that the Germans took. And when you see these films, I can't even repeat it. And I sat down on these benches, and I said to the guy that was there, I said, wow, these benches are very uncomfortable. Why is that? And he said, we don't want people to be comfortable when you watch these films. I was like, oh,
wow.
I said, okay.
No, and, I agree.
And I watched the films. And
you saw the gas chambers.
People dying. So please don't say, you know, it's insulting to the people.
It's
that
so offensive.
There. It's insulting. If I was Jewish, I'd be extremely insulted. Yep. I'm just a human being and I'm insulted.
Right.
So please don't say that. You're wrong. First of all, they were there these people, they're coming here to America.
They're in detention camps where they're treated humanely.
Humanely.
For
right.
what they did. The Jews were dragged out of their homes
yes.
for who they were.
And they were shot on sight.
It was awful.
It's not even in the same ballpark.
Please.
Don't say that, please.
Right.
You know, but
and what are you going to do? There's a lot of ignorance out there, Chaz. And, you know, for cheap political points, some people will say anything. And apparently she's one.
Exactly. I mean, this thing now they're giving people licenses. You know, I don't understand that. You know, you break the law and you get a license. Now, what about if we all say, you know what? I'm not paying my taxes this year.
Right.
Think about that. If we all got together, all Americans got together and said, you know what? We're just not going to pay our taxes.
Of course. I'm not going to pay that parking ticket.
I'm not going to pay that parking
ticket.
Any
of that stuff.
You know, I believe people have the right to come here, but you should come here. My parents did it, but you got to do it legally. That's
sure.
all.
Right.
That's all I'm
absolutely.
Saying. You got to have borders. You don't have a country unless you have borders.
You got to know who's coming into your country as well. I mean,
yes.
to have an orderly, safe environment, you need that.
I'm just trying to be a common sense American. I'm not a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I'm just trying to be common sense.
And you're making eminent sense as we
That's
speak
all
right
I'm
now.
Saying.
And you're smart because you have never told anybody, including me, and we're very close, who you really like. You say you're not a Republican. But with that said, he did kick off his new campaign last night for 2020,
right.
Donald Trump. So without saying who you prefer, what you like, if you had to predict, you do this with baseball and football, if you had to predict whether he'd win again in 2020, you think he wins again? You think it's a difficult road? What do you think?
I don't know. I mean, I just don't know. I mean, the way, you know, listen, think about it. No one thought he would win.
Right.
So if you believe that, wow, he actually won. So it actually could change the other way that fast.
Sure.
You don't know.
Nobody
you
knows.
Really don't know.
That's true.
So it is what
you know,
it is.
You know what we do know, Chaz Palminteri?
Yes.
We know that Bill de Blasio will not be president, despite the fact that he's thrown his stupid hat in the ring.
No, Bill will never be president. No. Now that I could open my mouth and say something. You know, because you want to take away a Columbus Day from right. us. No, that you make an enemy for life when you say that.
Yes, yes, Wilhelm.
That's over, though, right? We're done with that.
We're done with that. No, right. It's a landmark. I got to say, I give credit to Cuomo. He made it a landmark thing. They can never touch it again. God bless Andrew Cuomo for doing that. So I'm happy about that.
You know, do you watch the Tony Awards this year?
Yes.
Because, you know, your show was so good on Broadway. It was so good.
Well, thank
you. Really thought it should have won a Tony, for a musical. But I wonder now that it's not there right now, are you still as interested in Broadway as you were a year ago?
Yeah, I love Broadway. I come from the theater. That's where I came from. I love Broadway. I was very happy for the person who did the choreography for Bronx Tale. He won the Tony for Ain't Too Proud.
Oh, wow.
Sergio Trillo, who was just the best choreographer in choreographer. And this guy is so good.
Did you see that Ain't Too Proud?
No, I did not see it. No.
You grew up in the age of the Temptations, obviously.
Yes, I grew up in the Temptations, and they were great. And Sergio just took their dancing and made it his own. And he's brilliant. He's absolutely brilliant.
Well, listen, speaking of brilliant, Chaz Palminteri, that's you, and you're going to be at the Paramount Theater in Huntington this Sunday night at 7:30 performing your one-man show.
That's right.
It's going to be spectacular. You have to go check them out. Chaz, look, and also you're going to Paris to watch it.
I'm going to Paris to watch it. And everybody, I'll be at my restaurant.
That's
Chaz
right.
Palminteri's on 46th
Street between 6th and 7th.
Between 5th and 6th.
Jesus, will you wake up?
5th and 6th.
Between 5th and 6th.
And I'll be there. I'll be there later, in fact, and God bless you. You guys are great, man.
You're great, too, and your restaurant's terrific. I was there not that long ago. It was a marvelous, marvelous time. And as Bernie said, all these great things going on. Check out Chaz Palminteri Sunday night in Huntington. The show is amazing. More of Bernie and Sid right after this.
WABC.